I mean, who really wants to charge this with a cable anymore anyways? What's up, everyone? I'm Trisha Hershberger, and in this episode of DIY in 5, we're going to show you how to cut the cord and add wireless charging to your phone, the iPhone specifically. Want to know how to add wireless charging to your Android phone? Well, then be sure to subscribe to see all of our upcoming tips and tricks. First things first, know your standards. Like the battles of Betamax and DVD or memory stick and SD cards that came before, you can bet there is not one standard to rule them all when it comes to wireless charging. Once again, there's two standards competing to come out on top, Powermat and Qi. And of course, they're not compatible. From the outside, both standards work almost identically. There's a receiver that attaches to your phone and a charger pad that supplies the juice. Downside, using either of these standards will take longer to charge your phone than just plugging it into a wall. Upside, you do lose the ugly cable hanging off your phone when you cut the cord, so you give a little to get a little. Here's where it gets tricky when it comes to iPhone specifically. Sadly, like most Apple products, you can't bust open your phone and just add wireless charging. You're gonna need an external receiver for that. But never fear, there are tons on the market to choose from. You can pick up one of these patch versions that slides between your phone and case and plugs into your Lightning port. Or you can buy a case that has the receiver built in. If you go the case route, there are versions available which work with both Powermat and Qi charging pads, so you don't have to choose one or the other. You can expect to pay anywhere from $15 for the patch kind to $50 or more for the case versions online. Thanks, Apple. Now for the actual charging station. If you're looking for the most options in terms of cases and pads, you'll want to get Qi. More companies are making accessories that work that standard. But if you want to charge your phone at businesses with wireless charging available, like a Starbucks or McDonald's, then you'll want to go with Powermat. It offers businesses info about how much and how long people are using the chargers in their stores, which Qi can't provide. No matter which standard you choose, you'll need to get a charging pad that keeps you juiced up at home when you're not out getting caffeinated. Expect to pay around $25 for a charging pad that sits on your desk or nightstand, but there are also companies like IKEA that are building wireless charging right into the furniture. Love, love, love that stuff. Like seriously, just set your phone on your nightstand at night and boom! No looking for cables, charging! Set it and forget it! Sorry, it's really cool. So what are your thoughts on wireless charging? Is the cost worth the convenience? Let us know in the comments. Also, want to see how to shoot a time lapse with that new cord cutting phone of yours? Check out this video here. I'm Trisha Hershberger, and I'll see you next week with more DIY in 5.